There's the umbilical cord around the baby's neck.
It's okay.
I'm taking it off. Okay, I got her.
What's wrong? Why isn't she breathing?
Oh, no, she's okay.
She's not breathing.
Yes, yeah, she's gonna be fine.
She can't die.
She's not gonna die. Hey, she's not gonna die. Robin.
Congratulations, Robin. You have a healthy baby girl.
She's beautiful.
Yes, she is. She's perfect. She's a little girl.
Robin and Patrick had a beautiful baby girl. Oh. And they're doing really well. So Dr. Lee said you can go on in and see him. But family only.
Okay. Here. Send my warmest regards to the nascent parental units, okay?
Okay, thanks for telling. Matt.
Oh my God.
She said family, that means you too.
I don't want to push it.
She looks just like you. Oh, Robin, she looks like you.
She kind of looks like me. Okay, well, you two, it's time to name that beautiful little baby. Have you decided?
Yes, we have. We have decided on Millicent.
Oh, shut up.
I'm just kidding. Why don't you do the honors?
Everyone, I would like to introduce to you Emma Grace Scorpio Drake.
Oh, that's so perfect. Little Emma.
Ready to hold your little girl?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. Come on, the head. Okay, get the head.
Okay. Careful, careful, careful.
Right, bye. There you go.
Hi, Emma. I'm your dad.
Maybe she does look a little like you.
What is it?
It's nothing. It's just it's a little nick on her ear.
I think she's been exposed to it.
I think little Emma would be just fine, don't you?
So this shot is supposed to counteract any exposure to Robin's blood, right? And it's meant to be very effective. And besides, Robin's viral load is so low, it's virtually undetectable. Oh, I don't know about you, but I'm scared.
You know, I remember when Robin told me Stone had HIV and she'd been exposed. It was like her whole world had bottomed out, and mine. I never thought I could be this scared.
So completely unfair.
It's a most grave injustice indeed.
First Robin falls madly in love with Stone, and then he dies of AIDS. Then she gets HIV and has to pick up the pieces of her life. Then she decides she wants to have a baby more than anything, so she does, and now the baby might be HIV positive. I mean, what's next?
You must remain hopeful.
Certainly, you don't get it. Robin's a really good person. She's smarter and kinder and braver than I'll ever be.
Oh, come on. Now you're doing yourself an injustice.
Why can't Patrick and Robin just get married and have their baby and live happily ever after? And what about me? I want to be an aunt.
And a most fine one you will make.
I bought this really stylish snuggly the other day. I can't wait to put Emma in it. Or have Robin put Emma in it because I don't really know how to hold a baby. And I thought I would put her in this little sun hat and we can go window shopping on Main Street because I'm gonna teach her to be fashionable right from the start. And then at night, I'm definitely gonna tell her stories about her Aunt Georgie. I mean, that's all the stuff I dream about doing anyway.
Which will all most likely become a reality.
Unless it doesn't. Finally, I'm just really scared. Hey.
Hi.
How's Emma?
Top of her class. She scored a 9 on her APGAR test.
Her reflexes are excellent. She's strong, pink. She's basically perfect.
Okay, but did she take her AZT shot?
They're giving it to her right now. Epiphany's gonna bring her back in a couple of minutes.
Why are you being so calm? Emma could have been exposed.
Well, Kelly's testing her blood right now. We'll know tonight one way or another.
You know, I always knew that it could be a risk, but I never thought it would actually happen, and now that it's a possibility, it's...
Robin, I don't think she's infected.
Yeah, but what if she is? What if she is?
Then we'll deal with it as a family.
Right, but every single day she's gonna be burdened with the stigma and the prejudice and the protocol. I mean, you know, I'm an adult. I can deal with that, but for a little girl?
You're gonna be a great mother, no matter what happens.
Can you believe that you have a little girl? I mean, you didn't even want kids.
Yeah, but when I saw that little heart beating and her curled up in your stomach and, gosh, now that she's here, I love her more than I ever thought possible.
I know. Me too. It just breaks my heart to think that she might suffer because of me.
Mommy and Daddy. Baby Emma had her first shot today.
How'd she do?
Oh, she let out a healthy cry. She's got quite a set of lungs on her. Don't you, sweetheart?
Thank you for staying with her, Epiphany.
Oh, it's my pleasure. This little girl has won all the hearts of every single doctor, nurse, and technician in the maternity ward. Oh, it is time for her first bottle.
Can you be honest?
Now, don't be worried if she doesn't finish it all.
Okay.
I'm going to give you a little time before I let the rest of the family in.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Hey, sweetheart. You hungry?
She looks so tiny in your arms.
I wonder how tall she's gonna be.
Oh, hopefully taller than me.
Okay, you ready?
Yes, sorry. Oh. Hi. Oh. You know what? You are a miracle.
Yes, she is.
I can't even believe it. This little precious being with 10 fingers and 10 toes. It's our little baby. It's our child. It's crazy.
Everything is different.
I know, right? Before, the world was in black and white, and now it's in color. Just feed her in a little while. She's still sleeping.
Look at that. You're natural.
Either that or Emma's just a really good baby.
Don't speak too soon. She's got strong personalities on both sides of the family.
Very true. Wow, look at her. Emma, if I made you sick, I'm so sorry. Maybe you should take her.
No, I want you to hold her. Okay. I have to tell her something. Emma, I went through something like you went through not too long ago. Scared, and I was terrified, and I was falling apart, but you know who? Do you know who helped me through all that? Your mommy. She's the strongest person I know. She's been living with HIV for over 10 years now, and she's shown me what it's like to be brave and to be hopeful. And she's gonna do same thing for you no matter what happens, aren't you?
Well, you know, I'm not really the pillar of strength that your dad thinks I am. Sometimes I falter and fail, just like I did right now. But now, you are my inspiration. And I have your dad to remind me what amazing gift that life is. So as your parents, we promise you that no matter what happens, we're gonna give you a life full of joy and courage and gratitude for every single moment that we have together.